Yeah, well, Gene, really what we're talking about is all those snowmobile riders riding on the frozen lakes. And with all of the snow, that's another concern because, believe it or not, a lot of that snow can actually act as an insulin for that ice. And it can pose some very real dangers for snowmobilers.
It is a great time. There's been nothing more enjoyable in the wintertime for me than snowmobiling.
It's a way of life for Nick Thurston and friend Jose De Matos, who have been riding for decades. But even they know just how dangerous snowmobiling on frozen lakes can be.
Ice right now can be unpredictable with the amount of snow on top of it and the leaching of the water from underneath coming up and causing slush fields.
And people are getting stuck in the slush, and then there's not too much weight underneath that. And you go through and, you know, you're risking your life, you know.
Don LeClaire is a member of the Bridgewater Mountain Snowmobile Club. He spent Monday grooming land trails for other riders. He's another experienced rider who won't go near frozen water.
Believe it or not, that is a great insulator, snow, as people know, having it around their homes in the wintertime. And the frost starts to come out. The ice starts to melt from down bottom and comes up. And then the water rises and it wicks up into it. And consequently, then you have weak ice and then we have some disasters.
Just this past weekend, Fish and Game officers were on the scene of two snowmobile accidents that sent the machines into the water. The first was late Friday on Lake Winnesquam near the Mosquito Bridge. The second, sometime Saturday, in Franklin.
People definitely have been snowmobiling at night and on the lakes forever, it seems, since snowmobiles have come about.
Officers want to send a strong warning to riders who might not realize just because it's cold, that does not mean frozen water is always safe.
The ice is forever changing. Nothing's ever consistent. One day you can go across a very safe area that has lots of ice. The next day it could be no ice at all.
Yeah, a lot of concerns out there. And to put this all in perspective, DES is the agency that's responsible for making sure that if a vehicle does in fact go into the water, that it gets out of the water. Since 2007, they tell me they have had about 60 reports of machines going into the water. Reporting live from our Lakes Region Bureau, Adam Harding, WMUR News 9.